A new video. Today we are going to create a Pokédex application where we will get the list of the first 151 Pokémons shown in our Pokémon anime. In this application, we will be creating a grid view where the Pokémons will be distributed in two columns and in multiple rows. Here you can see we have been calling this Pokemon data from the API, and once we'll click on any one of the Pokemon, let's say I'm clicking on Charmander, it will take me to a new screen where we will get all the details of the Pokemon, his name, his type, height, weight, spawn type, weakness, pre-evolution, next evolution. So you can see Charmeleon and Charizard, the number, a bit of a good UI. So this is the application that we are going to build, Pokédex. Let's get started. I have created a project called as Pokédex. In our pubspec.yaml file, I have added few dependencies, Cupertino icons, HTTP to create API request from our Pokédex, a cached network image. The images that will be used from network we'll use in this. So the images will be cached as well by side by side. When time comes in the lecture, I will tell you how to use them. I've also created a images folder with the images folder over here, in which we will add our assets, and I've brought that images folder in an assets. Remember the indentation for images over here, it should be 4 and assets should be 2. Okay, so let's get started. First, before starting, I will add the Pokeball image in our images folder, which is in my desktop. You can get that image from GitHub source code. Control C, images, Control V, PNG, done. Okay, so I'll just play this application to let you know that we are still at the Flutter template application and have not done any changes. I will open main.dart as usual. Control A, delete everything. Void main. Run app. I hope you guys are familiar with this. Now we're going to create an application or a stateless widget that we will call inside our run app function. So stateless Pokédex, I will call that Pokédex over here, and this would be a material app. Okay, home. Now let's create our home file. You can usually create the home file in this main.dart file, but I prefer keeping the main.dart file and all the classes separate, so that if in future, maybe when we'll add themes and when we'll do the routing, we might use this class. So cancel, new .dart file, home screen. This will be a stateful widget. So stateful home screen. Now let us import material so that the errors will go. Let us add this home screen to our home and import the package as well. Done. Let us come back to our home screen. This will be a scaffold so that we won't have to create each and every minute details in our application body. Okay, now let us just give a background color so that we will come to know if our application is running or not. I'll hit the play button and we will wait for application to reload. Yes, our application has been loaded. That means the files that we created are working perfectly fine. Okay, now let us get the main file and the home screen has been successfully done properly. Now, first thing we will do is we will get the API of our Pokemon, from where we will get our Pokemon content. Okay, so for that, let us go and get the API. I have copied that. I have already opened the API in my Explorer Safari browser. Okay, and this is the URL from which you will get the API. So I have just copied it. I will mention below in the description You can copy the API from there. So I will create a variable over here, Poki API is equal to, and I have pasted it. Okay, now the important function or the important work that we have to do is when we will call this API like this into our application, we will get this data. And to get this data, we have to create a GET request. We have to create an HTTP GET request. So if we'll come to pub.dev, over here there is a nice package called as HTTP package, which is used to create an HTTP GET request. And you just have to copy this file from over here and paste it in our pubspec.yaml file, which I've already done in the start. Okay. And they have mentioned here how to create a GET request. So there is us, or they have told us how we should use this dependency. So let us get started. First, I will create home screen. I will create a function. Fetch Pokemon data. In this function, we will be fetching the Pokemon data. As they have mentioned how to import the HTTP package, I will copy this, copy, and I will minimize. I'll come at the top over here. I'll command V, control V, and now we have imported the HTTP package and we are set to create or to make an HTTP request. Okay. So if you'll open again, you will see var URL. They have created a variable called as URL. Let us do the same, and they have done a URI HTTP parsing over here. So let us do that over here. Is equal to URI.HTTP. Okay. HTTPS. Now, we have to write authority. Authority is the domain name from where you are going to get your API, or from where you are going to get your API data. So the domain will always be up to .com and after the two forward slashes. So just copy from here up to .com. Okay. Control C, the authority over here, control V. So we have done the authority. Unencoded path. The unencoded path is the path where we are going, we are making the request. So this is the domain, okay, to where we are going to make the request. And inside domain, this is the path where we are going. Okay. So just copy everything from here up to the end. Command C, command V. Okay, and there is one more object over here called as query. So this is the query. Now in this API, we don't need query, so I won't be able to show you, but there might be some URIs or URLs where you need to query, you need to limit something, or you need a data specific to your requirements. That time we need query. So the query will start always after the question mark. So whatever comes after question mark, you will add it inside the curly brackets over here. Okay. Right now we don't need it, so I'll skip that part. And after that, we will create an HTTP dot get request. And over here, I will write this URL dot then, because this is a future value. So when this HTTP dot get URL is functioned properly, then we will get a value over here. So this value, this will return a value which we get from this HTTP URL. So the first thing that we always check is that if the call or if the API request that we have made has been successful. So the success code of the API request we use is always 200. Whenever you make a request and your status code is 200, that means you have done a proper request. If you'll go to a web page, and if I will change anything from here and I hit enter, so now you can see 404, page not found. This 404 is the error code. Okay, when 404 means page not found is the error code. Just like the way 200 is a success code. So anything else apart from 200 means that there is no error. Okay, sorry, anything else apart from 200 means there is an error. So I'll first check the status code. Okay, I will just write print. Okay, I will remove the lambda function and create this normal function. So now let us print status code. So value dot status code. Okay, now I'll just create a function. I'll just create a button over here in body. Elevated button. Child will be text. I will write press button, and on pressed function I will just call the method fetch Pokemon data. Okay, now let us see what happens if I are going to get this data or not. Okay, if I'll press button, Flutter 200. That means the connection that we are making with the server is perfectly right. Our API call was perfect and the API status code is success. That means there was no error in our API calling. Our UR is also perfect. Now we will just print the body. Okay, so that we will come to know what data we are getting from our body. Okay, so I'll just press button. Okay, just the data that we got in the browser a few minutes ago is the data that we have got again. See, you can see that our API has, we have done a proper API call and we have got all the Pokemon data. You can see Pokemon Bulbasaur over here, Ivanosaur, and so forth and so far. Okay, so this is the complete data that we have got from our API calling JSON data. So what we have to do is, and that they have also mentioned in our HTTPS, you have to JSON.response, if you see JSON decode. Okay, we have to decode our JSON value. So let us create a new variable, decoded JSON data is equal to JSON decode value dot body. Okay, and now let us print decoded JSON data. Now let us see what we get over here. I've reloaded the application. I'm going to press button, and now this is the data that we have got, which we can use completely into our application. Okay, so I will create a list variable on top. We don't need this API now, but I will keep it anyhow. Var Pokedex will be a list. I won't initialize the list right now. This is the Pokedex, and I will write Pokedex is equal to decoded JSON data, and I will open this square brackets. Why? Because if you'll see, this is kind of a map string. Okay, this is a map string data, so we don't want, so we just want data, or we just want a map value which represents this Pokemon. Okay, so we want data from here up to the end. Okay, so decode JSON data, but what data we want in that? Data which value or whose value is Pokemon. Okay, now let us print Pokedex again. Print Pokedex. I will comment the decode JSON data print function. I'll hit command S to reload. I'll press button. Now you see we don't have the Pokemon written on the start. Just to show you the difference between the two functions, I'm going to print both the functions, or decoded JSON data and decoded JSON data with Pokemon as the key value. And I'll hit press button. Over here you can see we have got the entire map string of the API data that we get, and below we have just taken the data which has a key of Pokemon. So the entire data which has the key of Pokemon is been downloaded or is been separated from the entire decoded JSON data. There are many ways to parse this JSON value, but we are going to do proper root way so that you will understand how JSON work and how you can travel to and forth in the application. Okay. Now there might be chances that whenever you are making an API call, you might face some errors, you might make a wrong call, or the server might be down. So let us create a safe method. So in short, what I will do is I'll create an if function where value dot status code is equal to 200. Only then let the following method work. Okay, so I will wrap this method into a if statement. Okay, I will remove this print statement, and now we have changed the value of Pokédex which we have created or initialized on top. Let us give a setState function so that our value will get updated. Now I'll call this function in the init function of our application. So whenever our screen will load, fetch Pokemon data function will be called automatically. We don't have to call it separately, or there won't be a press button event. Okay, so I will create a init state, and over here when you're using a setState function into an init state, make sure that your view has been mounted before. So how we'll check? If statement and mounted. If the value is true, that means your view has been completely mounted, and now you can change the state of your screen or of the application. So fetch Pokemon data, and okay, just let me hit play button to check if our function is running without pressing the play button. I'm hitting the play button. Okay, there was no print function, so just give me a minute. Print Pokédex, command S, again play. Yeah, see, now without pressing any function we are able to get the value of our Pokemon. We are going to use this value into our screen. Now we are going to take this value from this Pokédex, and we are just going to put this value in our screen. Okay, now how will we just take a few part of this value or from this JSON data into our screen? Means what I mean to say is, if you want just this Bulbasaur name, how will you print that name? So it is simple. If you see, now we are in a list. We are in a list. It starts with a square bracket, the list, and it will end with a square bracket. Now the list is beyond our Android Studio to show. So it will end in this way, meaning that the data is still ahead and has truncated the string. Okay. Now it's list. It's an array. So if you want the first object in an array, you use 0. Okay. So to go inside the list of an array, I will create the square brackets and I will write 0. And if I hit and if I just press button, let's see what we print right now. Okay, let me just hit command S and I will hit press button. Yes. Now we have just printed the data of Bulbasaur. That is it. We aren't printing the complete Pokédex data. We have just taken Bulbasaur. Why? Because that was at the first place. Okay. And in an array or in a list, first place always starts with 0. The counting of array starts with 0. Simple. Now I want to print a name. So I will go one step ahead into our list. Just how we created a square bracket, I will create one more square bracket over here. And the string, I will write name. Okay. I will write this name. Command S, Control S in Windows. And I'll just press this button again. Bulbasaur. See, so from the entire list or the string of Pokédex, which was a map string, which we just took the Pokemon list, which has a list of all the Pokemons, and the list consists of the map string data. So in Pokédex, we came at our first integer, or let's say the first item in our list. I don't know if item would I don't know if item would be a proper sentence or the proper word over here. I don't know if item would be a proper word over here, but let's go with it. So the first item of the array, and of the first item, which will be a map string inside that array, we just want name. Okay. If I just change the number, if I go to 1, I think I would get Ivysaur. Just let me check. Yeah. Ivysaur. Sorry, my bad pronunciation is helping me again. And if I just hit 2, Command S. Oh. Venusaur. Okay. So these are the step by step Pokemon that you can get. Now, how we will put this list into our application screen? So for that, right now my main objective is to just put all the name of an application of the Pokemon into a grid view. So let us create a nice grid view inside an application where we will add all the Pokemons. And after that, we will check what kind of design we are going to make. Okay. So I'll remove this button, because now we don't need a button. We are getting the data directly whenever a screen is loading. So I'm going to remove this. So inside our scaffold, I'm going to call a grid view. Okay. Or let's say a column before. So column children. Whenever you call a grid view instead of column, you have to use expanded, because we want the grid view to take complete height and width of our application. Expanded child would be a grid view dot builder. Okay, we are going to build this application very nicely. Okay, it takes some required parameters that we are going to give. So the grid delicate will be a sliver, grid delicate with fixed cross axis count. Okay, and the cross axis count will be 2. Why? Because we want 2 boxes side by each other, or let's say we want 2 containers into a row. Cross axis 2, and child aspect ratio is 1.4. The item builder. Okay, before item builder, there is one more property which we need always, and that is item count. Our item count will be Pokedex dot length. So What item count means? Item count means the number of titles or the number of tiles you want inside a grid. This number is the item count, and the item count we want is Pokedex.length. So how much ever length of the Pokedex array will be, that many tiles we want. So for example, if our API gives us 10 Pokemon data, then a grid we will create 10 tiles. If our Pokemon API gives us 20, then the grid will create 20 tiles. But now we are getting roughly 151 Pokemon list. That means our grid view will create 151 tiles. Okay, and then item builder, which will take a context and index, and will return, and I will return a card view. Okay, so I'll return a card view, and just like how we printed over here name, let us print first the name of all the Pokemons. So child text, and in the text I will write, now we don't need string interpolation, I'll write Pokedex index. So this index will decide if it is the first Pokemon, second Pokemon, third Pokemon, fourth Pokemon, because this is the index, or this is the cell number of our tile, or you can say the tile number or the grid number, whichever grid we are into, index. And over here we want name, and hit command. I think I should just give a play over here so that we can check. Yes, now before loading the application there was a small red color screen, I'll just do it again, which was an error. And the error you can see is the getter length was called on null. This is the getter length that was called on a null function. Why? Because when an application loaded, we were still, our fetch Pokemon data function was still being running, and before we were getting any data, the layout loaded. That's why we got some error. Now how to tackle that? We will just give an if else command. Okay, so over here I just say Pokedex dot length is not equal to null. This means if the condition given over here is true, then run this part of the function, okay, which ends over here. And if this condition is false, that means if Pokedex.length is null, run this part. So we just want a circular loader right now. Okay, so I will just create a center child circular progress indicator. That is it. And I'll just hit a play button again for you to see the change that we have made. Yeah. Again, we are using the length function. We don't want the null function. Yes. You can see there was a small reloader at the top. Okay. Let's see again. Play button. Okay. Yes. Now we are not getting any error. Let us check our console. No error, everything is running fine. I will remove the print function over here. Done. This set state, just let me bring it to one line. Okay, done. Okay, so now we have got the Bulbasaur, Ivysaur, Venusaur, Charmander, Charmeleon, Charizard, and you can see all the data of Pokemon is over here. Now let me show you a website where you will find a nice design for Pokemon. This design is made by Syapul Navan. I hope I'm taking his name correctly. I love this design, and I'm just going to take some inspiration from his design. So he has just arranged the Pokemon into a grid view, just like we have done. And once we click on a grid view, a new page opens, which will tell us all the detailed information of the Pokemon that we are using. That's what a Pokédex does. Okay, and he has given a proper nice color to the card as per the type of the Pokemon. For it's a grass Pokemon, green, fire Pokemon, red, water Pokemon, blue, electric Pokemon, yellow. I'll try my best to get maximum possible colors, which we will try. Then you can see there is a nice title over here, the types of the Pokemon. Then the number, about. We just have this about because we don't have rest of this data. What all data we have, we will use inside this. Okay. So you can come to dribble.com and you can just search Pokedex app and we'll get this. Thanks buddy for such a nice design. Okay, I'll just keep the design open so that we can refer to it. Now, the main thing was to show the image. Okay, so instead of this card, I will just wrap this text into a column. And below text, I will just use cache network images, which takes URL. Okay, and the URL is Pokedex index image. Okay, that's where the URL is located. So Pokedex, the index image. Okay, just let me give a play button over here. Now let's see what we can see. Okay, we are getting error. Insecure HTTP is not allowed by the platform. But okay, now if you see, this is the link of the image. Okay, I'll just hit copy and let me minimize my simulator and just hit play. Enter. You can see the image is being loaded, so our URI is right, but it is saying HTTPS over here. But in our file, the link is HTTP. Okay, you can see the link is HTTP, and it is saying bad state or insecure HTTP is not allowed. So let us go back to cache. There is some changes that we have to do. So I'll open cache network. I think on this also should come cache network image. You can see 1660 likes, 90 per points, 99% popularity. Okay, we have copied this and added this into our pubspec.yaml. Okay, let us come down, paste. If you come over here, you can see open the info.plist file in iOS runner, then add the following attributes. Okay, we have to add this following attribute into our info.plist. So I'll just copy the iOS, not the macOS. Okay, control C. I'll come to my iOS folder Flutter runner info.plist, and at the end to paste it. Okay, application restarted, and you can see now all our images are present over here. Okay, let's come back and let me close minifies pubspec.yaml info.plist. Okay, so now if you see, where is this image? Let me close this. We don't need. So we have an arrow at the top over here, and then we have Pokedex written over here. We have this nice Pokeball image at the top. Okay, so let us start with creating the interface. But first, the most basic and the most easy interface would be to create the interface of this type or of this card inside the grid view. Okay, so let us start coding the
grid view. Now, if you see over here, the image of the Pokeball is behind, and on top of that image, there is Bulbasaur, or you can say the Pokemon. Then on the top corner, left side corner, you can see there is image of there. Sorry, there is the name of the Pokemon, and below is the Pokemon type. So what kind of Pokemon it is? Okay. So we are just going to copy this layout as much as we can. We will try our best to create exact layout, but let's see. Okay, so let's come back to our file, our Android Studio. Okay, let me close this. We are just going to work in this file, and now in this grid view, we are going to need a container. First of all, instead of card, we are going to use a container. Okay. Fine. So column, I'm going to just give a normal color right now. Colors dot green. Door application. Let us check. So yeah, each and everything has been green over here. Okay, each and everything has been green. Let us wrap this column into a stack view. Okay, so wrap with stack view. Stack view has children. Okay, just give this column where this column ends over here. Let us close the stack array. Okay, now instead of in the stack view, I want a image at the bottom right corner. Okay, so I will take image from our asset. So dot asset images pokeball.png. It should be inside our children. Okay, so we have this image over here. We have to just shift this image over here to the bottom right corner. So first of all, I will give a nice height and width to our image. Okay, so the height will be 100, fit box fit dot width fit height. Okay, and I will wrap this widget into a positioned widget. Okay, so what will a positioned widget do? It will tell us, or it will arrange this image into a nice position as we want. So from bottom, I want -10. I want the image to go a bit below so that it would get a nice clipping effect. And on right, I want -10 as well. So if you see, yeah, we have got this image. Okay, let me reduce. Fine. Okay, this is fine. Now let me remove this column over here. We don't need column now. Okay, so this cached network image, this image of our Pokemon, we will shift this image also on this Pokeball. So I will wrap it again with positioned widget. Okay, and the position of that image will be same, bottom will be say 5, we don't want this image to go below bottom, and right 5, command S. Okay, it's good, it's looking good so far, it's good. Now let me open to check the design. Okay, yes, nice. Now we have to just take this text a bit below. Okay, so text wrap with widget positioned. So top I'll give 50. Let's give a guess. Left will be 20. Control S. No, 50 is too much. So top 20. Okay, yeah, and below this text we want to show the type, which type the Pokemon is. Okay, you can see the which type this Pokemon is. So I will just copy and let us create a variable over here. Variable type is equal to Pokédex. Index type, and the reason I'll tell you in a few minutes, the reason I'll tell you later why we did that. Okay. So the text I want type to string. Okay, yeah, so type is coming there. So I'll just give a bottom 40. And we just want the first type. Most of the Pokemons are single type or dual type, but their first type is the main type. So what I'll do is type. And in type I'll again come 0. So the first type. Okay, grass. Okay, now this text type I'm going to wrap it into a container. I'm going to give padding to this text over here, and only left will be 8. Right will be 8, top 4, bottom 4. So we will get a proper cubic kind of structure over here. Okay, container. Okay, let me give this container a light color. Yeah. So we have given a slight box type decoration to our text over here, just like they have given over here. Now let's create this curve. Now let's give a curve. Okay, so in container there is this decoration property, box decoration, border radius dot all. So we want radius from all sides. Radius dot circular 20. Command S will throw an error because we are not giving the color property inside the decoration. So I'll just copy this color from here and paste it here. Command S. Now the error will go and we have got a proper nice curved block of type, what type of Pokemon it is. Okay. Venusaurus, grass, Charmeleon, fire. Most of the thing is done over here. Okay, I'm just now going to add the style to the text. Now we're going to add style to the text. So first style I will add to the name. Just let me take this down. Style, text, style. Okay. I'm going to give font weight bold. Font weight will be font weight dot bold. Font size, let's see, 18, command S. Okay, yeah, 18 is good. 18 is doing nice. Okay. Yeah. Okay, 18 is doing nice. Image. Okay, we'll just reduce this cache image. I'll just give height of 100 and I'll fix it. So fit box fit not fit height. It's okay. Yeah, so we have reduced a bit of the image size so that we will have space over here and it's still visible properly. Okay, now we will give the remaining style to our text widget. Okay, so if you have given bold, color should be white. Colors dot white. Let me give this command S. We want to give it this over here. Name. Okay. And text style. Text style, we just want to change color. Command S, done. Okay, so we have got this Bulbasaur, we have got Venusaur, we have got Charmander, we have got Charmeleon, we got Charizard, Squirtle, War Turtle, Blastoise, Caterpie. Okay, now let us give a bit of this round edges. So instead of this card, I'm going to make this a container. And this color I'll cut. I'll take decoration, box decoration. Okay, inside this box decoration color, then again border radius dot all radius dot circular 20. Command S, Control S, yes, nice. And padding should be symmetry. Vertical will be 8, horizontal 12. Okay, yes. So now we have created this nice layout: Bulbasaur, Ivysaur, Venusaur, Charmander, Charmeleon. Okay, now one of the most important thing that we have to do over here is this top Pokédex title. We are not going to use back button because this is the first screen. We don't have any back screen. And this Pokédex over here, this Pokéball that we have to add over here. Okay, let me minimize. And now let's get started with that part of a. So what I'll do is I'll wrap this complete grid view, this complete column into a stack, into a stack view. I'll remove this child and I'll turn them to children. Okay, so that we can add items. Let me close the square bracket of a tag. Yeah, done. So now we have arranged our entire grid view inside a column. Let me hit play button and check if it's messing up the design. No, so far no, the design is right. Okay, and after that I am going to wrap our stack view, or sorry, our grid view, this grid view inside the position widget. Okay, so this column, I'm going to wrap this widget into position widget, where top I will give 150 and bottom will be 0 and width will be width, whatever width we need. Okay, now we are going to need this width, so let's calculate the width of our file, of our screen. So I'm going to create a variable media query var width is equal to media query dot of context size width, and if I'm here I'll just calculate height. Media query dot height. Okay, so we have height and width. So here we got width, command S. Okay, see, so our grid view has been pushed a bit down. Okay, a grid view has been pushed a bit down from top. Done with the grid view part, and now let us create the top part where we write the Pokédex and where we have given our Pokeball image. Okay, so stack, on stack I'm going to write position widget, because we are going to need position, we have to position the text. Child will be image dot asset images slash Pokemon dot png. Top, I guess, minus 50, right minus 50, and the image width I'm going to give I'm going to fit that image, fit box fit dot fit width, so that the width should be fit and height should be auto. I hit play, nothing. Okay, let me check my image. Project structure. Pokeball.png. Okay, yeah. So you can see there is this image over here. A nice Pokeball image. See a nice Pokeball image that we have over here. Okay, and now you have to write text. So I will just take a text. I'll write Pokédex index. So now let's give text, the Pokédex text which we had over here. So I'll just take a text file and I'll write Pokédex over here. I'll wrap that Pokédex into our positioned widget. Okay. And let us start by giving position. So top will be same, I guess, 50, left 20, and is Pokédex. Yeah, and now this style. Text style, font size 20, font family, no, font weight, font weight, font weight dot bold, color will be colors dot white. Command S. Where is my head? Blank. Okay, Pokédex. Let's increase the font bit. 30, yeah. So Pokédex. Okay. Yeah, so that we'll have some padding below. Okay, now this is Pokédex over here. Okay, connection refused. Okay, fine. Don't worry, still going to run. Pokédex, Bulbasaur, Ivysaur, Venusaur, Charmander. So I think our first page is almost ready. Now we just have to give the color according to the type. Okay, we have to give the color according to the type. So I am going to minimize this. Where is our color given to our card? So container decoration green. Yeah, so instead of that, what I am going to do, we are going to create an if else statement. So type that we have created on top. Okay, this type, yeah, this variable type. So type is equal to grass, we want colors dot green. Okay, what do we want? Colors dot green. And if not that, I want colors dot red. So now what will happen? All the Pokemons who have grass as a type will be green, and rest everyone will be red. Okay, rest everyone will be red. Okay. This color, let me go to green accent. Okay, so green. Okay, yeah, green accent over here. Then if else, if type is equal to fire, I want color to be red accent. Okay, let me minimize this and let me just give colors fast to each and every type. Then I think comes water type. If type is equal to water, I want colors dot blue. Okay, over here if type is equal to electric. Okay, if type is equal to electric, I want color colors dot yellow. If type is equal to rock, I want colors dot gray. If type is equal to ground, if type is equal to ground, I want colors dot brown. We are going to cover as many types as we can. Okay. If type is equal to psychic, we want indigo color. Type is equal to after psychic, I think it's fighting. I want colors to be orange. Type is equal to after fighting, let's go for bug. If type is equal to bug, light green accent. Ghost Pokemon is also there. Type is equal to ghost, colors dot deep purple. Type is equal to normal will be black 26. Black 26, and else if the type is out of this, so the type is something which we haven't mentioned in this, then colors dot pink. Okay, when I hit the play button, see now according to the type, poison, where is poison? Poison, no, we haven't added poison. Poison is left. Type is equal to poison, S-O-N.
Yeah.
So poison Pokemon, grass Pokemon, bug Pokemon, ground Pokemon, normal Pokemon, water Pokemon, fighting Pokemon. Okay, water, psychic Pokemon, fighting. Okay, almost each and every Pokemon has a color now. Okay. Now what we have to do is, once we click on this screen, it should take us to the new screen where all the details of the Pokemon will be given. Okay, so let us give a onTap function to this. So I will just wrap our container. Okay, where is my container? Yeah, this padding. I am going to wrap my padding into a inkwell. So inkwell means it will give a bit of a materialistic design and ripple effect on the tab. And on tab, let's navigate to new detail screen. Okay, so let us create a new detail screen. So I'll come back to my lib folder, cancel, new dot file. Pokemon detail screen will be a I don't know, might be a stateful, might be a stateless, so we'll convert, we'll go with the flow. Okay, I will write Pokemon detail screen REEL screen. I'm going to import material over here. I've imported material. Let us change this container to scaffold. Okay, background color, I will give right now colors dot red just to check. Okay, and I'll come back to my home screen and I'm going to navigate from first screen to second screen. Okay, so navigator, navigator dot push context. We are going to use material page route. Okay, and Pokemon detail screen. Okay, so now let me explain you this function. So a navigator, you must have heard this term. Navigator is something which helps you go from one place to another. Okay, so whenever you travel or whenever you go from one place to another, that is called navigating, and the one who helps you to navigate from one place to another is called as a navigator. So we are calling the navigator function. Okay, so now there are two kinds of navigator. One is when you push something on top of the other. So when you move ahead, that is called pushing, and the opposite of push is usually pull, but over here we use pop because the layouts are arranged in a stack view, one on top of the other. So when you push, you add a layer on top of the other, and when you pop, you remove the top layer. So navigator.push. Push from where? From the context, wherever we are present right now. To go from place A to place B, you should know where A is, right? Yes, so this place A, you are telling a navigator that I am on screen A and I want to go somewhere. Now, to navigate from place 1 to place 2, you need three things. One is the navigator, which is going to take you place A and place B. And second, the path, how you are going, okay? The route, the route, you can say route, okay? Then material page route or material page route, that will decide our route. It will build the route and then it will take us to Pokemon detail screen. That is how this navigation function is working. This is a navigator. this is the way, you can say the path, and this is point A and this is point B. So from point A to point B, there is this path which is taking us. Okay, so that's how navigation is done. So let us check if our application is actually navigating from screen 1 to screen 2. Yes, it is actually going from screen 1 to screen 2. Very well. Okay. Now we are going to transfer this data of Pokemon from screen 1 to the second screen, because we will need to show this data on the second screen. So to transfer this data, I'm going to open second screen and I'm going to create some variables. I'm going to initialize or declare some variables. So variable or final Pokemon details. Okay, according to that, we will need the color of the first screen to the second screen. Like, just pass the color instead of doing all the calculation over here. Okay, so final color, and we are going to use hero animation. So I'll just use and that animation needs a tag. In future, I will tell you what it is, but let's now just create that variable. Okay, so int hero tag, and now it's showing an error. The final variable Pokemon details must be initialized. I'll just create the constructor by using this boilerplate, create constructor, and I'll come back over here. Okay, and now let us add. Pokemon detail screen. Okay, Pokemon detail will be our Pokédex index. We don't want to transfer the entire Pokemon's details. We just want to transfer the details on which the user has clicked. So index, okay, and color will be right now colors dot red. Okay, it won't make any change. Let's take green, and index hero tag I'll just create. Index right now. Okay, so instead of passing this green color, what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy the colors that we have created over here. Okay, of type. So if this is the type, then what color we are going to pass? I'm just going to copy this color from here to here. Control C, and this colors will go over here as well. This will be easier for us. Now I'll come on my Pokemon details screen. Instead of color, I will just add widget dot color over here. That's what we wanted. Okay, now let us create the second screen of our application. Okay, so we have done this part where we are about to make proper background color according to the Pokemon. I'll minimize this. Okay, now let's come back to the second screen, Pokemon detail screen. Okay, background is fine. I'm going to wrap this background into a stack view, just like we did it previously. Then I'm going to give background color as widget dot color. Then I'm going to wrap, then I'm going to create a stack view. Body will be a stack where children. Yes, now the first thing that we're going to do is create the bottom container. Okay, we are going to create the bottom container where we will write everything. Okay, so now let us create a container. We will need height and width, so I'm going to create height and width over here again. Media query dot off. Okay, so we got height and width of our application of the screen, and now we are going to create this container. So the width of the container should be complete. Width, the height of the container, I want height into 0.6. I'll hit command S, nothing will happen. I'll give color to the container, colors dot white. Yeah, so this is the container, but I want container to be shifted below, so I will wrap that with position widget. Positioned bottom 0 and command S, done. Okay, so the container is a bit curved from two sides, okay, from top left and top right. So let me remove this and let me give a decoration, box decoration, border radius dot, instead of all we are going to take only, okay, then top left will be radius dot circular 20 and top right will be radius dot circular 20. Let us see what we can see. Yeah, and color, colors dot white. Okay, so see, we have got this proper cut or clip, rounded corners, which I'm going to increase a bit. Yeah, okay, we want a Pokemon over here, we want the name of the Pokemon over here. Okay, so first let us start with the Pokeball image that we are going to use. Again, image.asset, images, Pokeball.png, height will be 100. Fit box, fit dot height. Okay, I'll hit command S. Okay, so this is the image over here. Width 100, box fit dot fit, width. I'll just use height and I'll just increase the height over here by 200. Okay, yeah, this is the height of the image. Then I'm going to wrap this image into a positioned widget because we don't put it over there. So wrap with widget positioned. Okay, and the position that I want is top 10, right minus 10. Let us see what I get. Yeah, so we got this image over here. I want this image to be shifted more below. Okay, so instead of taking this dynamically, what I'll do, I'll take height in
to 0.5. okay. Hmm. 0.2, 0.18. yeah, nice. Now this image, now I just want this image below, I want this image below this container, so I'll just copy it, positioned widget, okay, and I'll paste this on top of our container. Control X on top of the container, this went. Control S, yes, I can see. And the right, I want it more shifted to the right. Yes, minus 30. So this is the Pokeball that we have over here. Now let us give the title. Let us give title. Text. Widget. Widget. Pokemon details. Name. Okay. Okay. I will wrap it with positioned widget. And this position that I'm going to give will be top 25 and left 5. Okay, this is the name. I think top will be more 50, 70. Okay, I guess 70 is nice top. Style, text, style, okay. Like we want a bit, we want the back button also. I will make this 80. Okay, icon button, icon, icons dot back arrow, color, colors dot white, and size 20, and on press means we have to go back, so navigator dot pop context. This will also, we must wrap it into position widget. Okay, top I will keep 70 and left I will keep 20 as well. Command S. Okay. I guess 30 would be a nice size. Okay, done. So if I click on this back button, okay, it is taking me back. Okay, everything is working nice till now.
let us add image positioned. Again, we are going to this position, so positioned child will be cache image network image. Image URL will be widget dot Pokemon details. Okay, yes, what we have done, we have taken this image and I've given a random position, let's say position top 100. So from top 100 and from left it is width divided by 2, but then this won't be in center. So what I'll do is this width divided by 2 is the starting point, and width divided by 2 minus half of height or width minus 100. Okay, so this is in the center now on an average, and from top we are going to need, what's the size of container, height into 0.6, and from top it is position 10, 0.18. So from top it should be height into 0.18, this value, because this is the value of our container. Command S. Okay, plus 100. No, fine, the same height would be fine. Okay, so now this height is over there. Now we have to give the type. Fine, okay, where is this positioned name? Okay, so below this I will write the text will be widget dot Pokemon details type, and I'll wrap that into positioned widget. From top I want hundred, left 20. To string, because that's a list. Okay, grass and poison. Okay, let's take a bit below 120, 140. Fine, and now we have to remove this list array and this comma. So what I'll do is this toString, I'm going to give dot join dot join okay. So what happened by join, this list will be turned into a string. Okay, and this will join it by this comma, and I have added a space purposely so that they won't be stuck to each other like this. So a space. Okay, so now we have grass and poison. These are the types. Okay, these are the two types. I'm going to give them style, text style. Just colors dot white. This text I will wrap with a container decoration, box decoration, border radius. I'm doing this again and again, so it will be able for you to memorize it. Border radius dot all radius dot circular 20. Color black 26. Okay, done. A bit padding. Only left. Okay, so grass poison, this other type of this Pokemon, and below we have to write the data. Okay, so let me come into this. Container. Child will be a column. The column will have name, text, name, commanders. Okay, this is name. So column main axis alignment main. Okay, and I'm going to wrap this name into a row. And this one has a children. And I will just wrap this into a container whose width will be width into 0.3. Child text. And main axis of the row start. Okay, and size box height 50, because we want our name to be a bit below. Okay, we don't want it completely on top. 50. Okay, and this will get a nice padding. Okay, so name this container. So name Bulbasaur. Okay, this name, this is Bulbasaur. Let us give style, text style, color dot blue gray, font size 18. Okay, the same text style I will take for this. Okay, here the font size will be 18, blue gray will be black, font weight dot bold. Okay, name Bulbasaur. So this I'm going to wrap with a nice padding. Now this I'm going to copy. After name, I want height. HD height. After height, I want weight. Okay, so name, height, weight. So spawn time, I think it should be 10 seconds. After spawn time, we have to show weakness. So over here, weaknesses. W should be small. Okay, weaknesses. And for this, we don't want the limit. Let the limit be 5, as ice, flying, psychic. Okay. Name Bulbasaur, height 0.7 meters, weight 6.9 kg, spawn time 20, weakness fire, ice, flying, psychic. This is the weakness. Now after that, we are going to do the evolution part. Okay, so if you see, yeah, the evolution part is in a map string form, so we cannot use over here. If I take this, it is going to throw me an error. Okay, it is going to throw me an error. Evolution, this is going to throw an error. A non-null string must be provided to a text widget. Okay, so what we're going to do is we are going to create a small list view. Okay, so everything will be fine as much as it is. So this container, I'm going to remove this container. Okay, this is center text widget. Okay, in this container I'm going to take a sized box, maybe. Yeah, a sized box where I'm going to give a height of 20 and a width of 0.55. okay, the child will be a list view dot builder. Now item count, okay, now so pay attention how we are going to create the item count. The item count will be widget dot Pokemon details. In Pokemon details we will go into next evolution. Inside the next evolution I want the current dot length. This will be the item count, okay, dot length. And item builder will be context and index. Return will be a normal text widget, okay, and the text widget will be widget dot Pokemon details next evolution evolution. In next evolution we will go to index, because there might be two evolutions, there might be three evolutions, right? So one evolution, two evolution, three evolution, and name, okay. And whenever return we use a colon. Command S. I hope this should work. Okay, just let me give scroll direction. Okay, see, so now we have got it over here. Length, I am going to wrap this with padding only, and write, okay, and this style will be same style. So I'm going to copy this style from over here to here, control C, okay, Venusaur, okay, evolution. Before evolution I need one more thing, okay. Now what if the Pokemon is Charizard? If you'll see over here, if I come to Charizard, it will throw an error. Why? Because Charizard doesn't have this evolution. So before creating this listview.builder, I'm going to write over here widget.pokemonDetails next evolution is not equal to null. If this is not equal to null, then I want this size box, and if this is null, I would write a simple text which will say maxed out with the same style, okay, with the same style. Command S. Now Charizard maxed out, okay, maxed out. So this is the as there is evolution, there also is a previous evolution, like a step before, okay, previous form. So let us take that also. So this container padding, I'm going to copy this from here. I'm going to paste this on top over here. Now instead of next evolution, it's prev evolution. Preform. I'm going to copy this over here. Control V. Control V. And instead of max out, I will write just hatched, because this Pokemon, they hatch from an egg. So just hatched. Nothing can be previous than just hatched. See Charmander. Preform just hatched. Charizard, oh, preform is Charmander. Charmeleon, Charmeleon, preform is Charmander. Evolution is Charizard. So guys, finally our application of this Pokédex is completely ready. Each and everything is working completely fine. We have the name Bulbasaur, we have grass, poison, its type, name Bulbasaur, height is 0.71 meters, weight is 6.9 kgs, is spawn time is 20 seconds, weakness is fire, ice, flying, psychic. Preform is just hatched, this is the youngest version I guess. Then evolution is Ivysaur and Venusaur. Let's check Charmeleon. Charmeleon, height 1.09 meters, weight 19.0 kg, spawn time 19 seconds. It takes 19 seconds to come out maybe. Weakness, water, ground, rock. Preform, Charmander. Evolution, Charizard. Type, fire. This is the application, Pokédex. Okay. Ekans, Arbok, Nidorana. Okay, so this is male. And Nidoqueen, this might be female. Yes, finally our Pokédex application is completely ready and you can try it. Do let me know in the comment which application you want me to create next. In this application, let me just brush you up very fastly. In this application, what we have learned is how to create the API, how to call this API function. So what we have done, we have created a fetch Pokemon data function where we have called the API. So we have taken the authority over here. This is the authority, raw github user content.com. This is the unencoded path. Then we have created, then we have called this function http get URL. This URL, when we get this URL, then we are getting the value. This is a callback. Then we first check if value dot status code is equal to 200. Then when the status code is 200, then only we decode the JSON file into this value dot body, and we just take the Pokemon from the decoded JSON data and we are setting the state. Once we set the state, we call the grid view over here. If you see the grid view over here, and the grid view is taking the delegate of sliver grid delegate with fixed cross axis count. We give the cross axis count 2, we give child aspect ratio 1.4. After that, the item count means the number of tiles inside the grid should be pokedex.length. The item builder is context index, and then we are taking the type to arrange the color according to the type. The color, if it is grass type, the color should be green accent. If it is fire type, the color should be red accent. If it is electric, the color should be yellow, etc. and etc. Then we are adding this Pokeball image over here behind inside the stack view. Then we are writing the name Venusaur, giving the style. Then we are writing the type of Pokemon it is. It's a grass type, fire type, what kind of Pokemon it is. Then we are taking this image from Cascade Network Images. Okay. Once we click, we should go to the next screen. So we have written the onTap function over here. And just let me shift this black to gray. Okay, now once we click on this tile, it is going to take us to the new screen. Okay, and just remember, instead of doing this black 26, just make it gray over here. Okay, and then we are giving the hero tag. Yes, this is the part which was a bit remaining. I just missed out. So what I'm going to do very fast, I'm going to just wrap the image widget over here. Where is my image? So what is hero tag? It is kind of an animation. When we transit from one page to another, we can give a nice sweet animation to our images. So just let me find where I've written the image code. This is the image positioned. Okay, so I'm going to wrap this image in a hero and tag will be widget.hero tag. Okay, command S, and I'm going to wrap this image over here in a hero and the tag will be index. Why? Because you cannot repeat a same tag. So this tag will be dynamic. Okay. So for first Bulbasaur, the tag will be 1. For Ivysaur, the tag will be 2. For Venusaur, the tag will be 3. So the application or the hero won't be confused between what kind of, so that hero won't be confused which tag is going where. Okay, so I have paused it. Now if I'll click, yes, you can see this sweet animation, this zoom animation that I'm getting over here. Then the Ivysaur animation I'm going, yeah, this was the hero tag animation. It is so easy to understand. What you have to do is you have to make sure that the tag from the first screen is equal to the tag on the second screen, and that's why we are passing the tag over here. We are passing this hero tag of index over here, so that we have given this hero tag index over here, which we are passing in the next screen, and that next screen hero tag we are calling over here. So the image has the same tag, and that is why you are able to see this animation. I had completely missed about this hero tag. Okay, yes, so finally I can say that my application is ready, Pokédex. Go through it, try to do it on your own. If there are some applications that you have in your mind which you want us to do it, do let me know in the comment section. Also, please like, subscribe, comment, share, because there are a lot of efforts going behind this video. I hope you all know we are doing a lot from our side to help the community. See you later. So please do like, share, comment, tell your friends, whatever you can do. Okay, in the description below you will find the source code and all the data that you need for this application. Bye bye.